गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
सो इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टार्टेड विथ सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम एंड वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट सोर्सेस एंड रेजिस्टेंस नेटवर्क। ओके, then next type is in superposition theorem there are two types of problems. One is if only independent sources are there, voltage and current, and along with them resistances are present. And in second type of problem, if dependent sources are present, then do you remember what we have to do if dependent sources are there in superposition theorem? Yes, Avi, what we are supposed to do, whether we have to consider it as a source or we have to keep it intact as it is. So our problem is in this, use the superposition theorem to find what we want to find. It is asked current through 6 ohm resistor. Okay, so we are interested to find current through this 6 ohm resistor. There are three sources. One is 15 volt battery, which is independent source, 10 volt battery, which is independent source, and one more current source is there, which is a dependent source, 3 times I, where I is this current flowing through 6 ohm resistor. So in superposition theorem, what we are doing, we are considering one source at a time, right? So here we have to consider this 15 volt once, 10 volt once, and what to do about 3I, this current source, whether we have to treat it as a source third time. Yes, others, Siddhi, Poonam, Priyanka, do you remember? Okay. If not, I'll tell you that the source, you have to keep it intact. What do you mean by intact? Intact means as it is. So we'll consider only 15 volt source once, and second time we'll consider 10 volt source. So this dependent sources, you have to keep it as it is, as if it is a resistance or so. So we need not have to replace it by any either short circuit or open circuit. Okay, so let us start the problem. So there are two sources, 15 volt and 10 volt. Let us begin with only 15 volt source is acting. So when 15 volt source is acting alone, that means this 10 volt battery, you have to make a short. As it is a voltage source, we'll replace it by a short circuit. If it would have a current source, we would have replaced it by a open circuit. But this is a 10 volt battery or voltage source, so we have replaced it by a short circuit. only 15 volt source is operating, and this 6 ohm and this resistors, they are intact along with this diamond dependent current source. So it is also in the circuit. Okay. Now it is a simple problem, a mesh analysis. So there are two meshes. So mesh 1 and mesh 2. And there is a current source in between two meshes. So if a current source is common between two meshes, it is a problem of super mesh. So this is a problem of super mesh. So we have to tackle it as if it is a super mesh. So how we are tackling super mesh problems? For super mesh, we need two equations since two unknowns are there. So what we'll do? We'll write first a current equation from the common branch consisting of a current source. So I2 minus I1, since the I2 direction is same as that of this current source direction, so I2 minus I1 will be this 3 I dash. We have assumed that initially when this 15 volt source, only this 15 volt source is operating, current flowing through this 6 ohm resistor is, let us say, I dash. So that 3 times I dash is this current source. So the relation between these two currents, you can write it as I2 minus I1 is equal to 3 I dash. So this is one relation we have got. Another relation, we have to find it by a superposition applying applying KVL to this super mesh. So you apply KVL to this super mesh. So what it will result? 15 equal to 15 minus this equal to 0, right? So 15 minus 6 I1 minus 8 I2 equal to 0. Rearrange the terms. So it will become 6 I1 plus 8 I2 equal to 15. Let us say this is one equation, equation number 3. And we have got this I2 minus I1 is equal to 3 I dash. Okay, this is one equation. Now we know, since dependent source is there, so for dependent source, what is the quantity on which we are depending? It is 3 I dash. So that means it is a current dependent current source. So we should find out the relation between this dependent current source. So this I dash and your variable I1. So what is the relation between I dash and I1? I1 direction and I dash direction both are same. So I dash is equal to I1. Substitute this value of I dash equal to I1 in this equation. I2 minus I1 equal to 3 I dash. So it will become I2 minus I1 equal to 3 I1. Take this 3 I1 on another side, or club the terms of I1 together. So it will result 4 I1 minus I2 equal to 0. Let us say this is one of the equation of two variables, and this is another equation of two variables. Solve these equations number 2 and 3 here to get I1 and I2. So using calculator you can do that. And I1 value, I have got it as 0.39 and I2 as 1.59. So what is I dash? I dash is nothing but it is same as I1. So I dash value is 0.39 ampere, and current is flowing from left to right in 6 ohm resistor. So this is one current we have found out flowing through 6 ohm resistance when only 15 volt source is operating. Right. Now, second step is you replace this 15 volt source by a short circuit and operate only this 10 volt source. Okay, so that is the second step. When only 10 volt source is operating, that means 15 volt source I have short circuited and only 10 volt source is operating. Again, it is a simple two mesh. Two meshes are there. Again, it is forming a super mesh. So find out again the relation between this current. So write one current equation and apply KVL to this super mesh. So you will result two equations. And since a dependent source is there, you have to find the relation of this I double dash. Now for this second time, this 10 volt source is operating. So I assume that current flowing through this 6 ohm resistor is now I double dash. Okay. So relation between this I double dash and your currents, mesh currents, that you have to find out. So this I double dash is equal to I1. So I double dash is I1. Let us say this is one equation. Then find out the current relation from this. That is I2 minus I1 is equal to 3I double dash. Now again I double dash is I1. Substitute that value here. So I2 minus I1 is equal to 3I1. So it will result 4I1 minus I2 equal to 0. So this is one of the equation of two variables, with two variables. We want another equation with two variables so that we can solve them simultaneously. So another equation you can find out by applying KVL to this super mesh. So what it will result? This 10 volt minus 6 into I1 minus 8 into I2. That is equal to 0. So it is minus 6 I1 minus 8 I2 plus 10 equal to 0. From this you will get 6 I1 plus 8 I2 equal to 10. Let us say this is equation number 3. So you have got two equations of I1 and I2 and two unknowns. So you can solve these two and three equation to get values of I1 and I2. So I1 value we got it as 0.26, I2 as 1.05. And what is I double dash? I double dash, that is 6 ohm, current flowing through 6 ohm resistor is nothing but I1. And its value is 0.26 ampere. And it is flowing from left to right. So when only 15 volt source was operating, the current was I dash and it is 0.39 and it was flowing from left to right through 6 ohm resistor. And when only 10 volt battery was operating, the current flowing through this 6 ohm resistance is 0.26 ampere and it is also flowing from left to right. So you have to add them algebraically, and since the directions are same of both the currents, directions are same, so simply you have to add them. So 0.39 plus 0.26 will become 0.65 ampere, and which is flowing from left to right. So that we have found out. Okay, understood? Then one more problem we'll tackle of dependent source. Now we have seen current source. Now we'll see the voltage source. So if it is a voltage dependent voltage source. So what is asked? I'm unable to see because of this. Using superposition theorem, we want to find current through I1. So current through this I1 we want to find. Okay, current I1 means this I1, 10 ohm resistor. Current flowing through this 10 ohm resistor we are interested to find. And there are two sources. One is this voltage source, one is this current source. And this is a dependent source. And since polarity is given, it is a voltage source. And 4 Vx is written side to that diamond block. So what do you mean by that? It is a voltage dependent voltage source. Okay, and that Vx is nothing but the voltage at this particular point. This particular point. Okay. So what we have to do? We have to initially use only one source out of these two sources. One is 5 volt source, another is 2 ampere source. So let us take this 5 volt source is operating first. So this 2 ampere current source, you have to make it open circuit. And this dependent source and these resistances, you have to keep it intact. So as it is in the network. So this 2 ampere current source is open circuit. So the resulting figure is this. 2 ampere current source I have removed. Only 10 ohm resistance, 5 volt battery, this Vx, this 4 Vx, and this 2 ohm. So this is the network. So it is very simple now. What we want to find, first, since dependent source is there, we have to find this relation of this Vx first. Okay, so how to calculate this Vx? Vx, from this you can calculate, if current I1 dash is flowing in this direction from bottom to top, that means if you want to mark polarity of voltage across this resistor, how it will be? Positive terminal will be here and negative terminal will be here, because current is entering at this particular point. So this terminal is positive. This terminal of battery is positive. So both the positive terminals are connected to each other. So that means it will be subtraction of the voltages. Okay. So 5 minus 10 I1 dash will be the voltage at this particular point. That is nothing but Vx. So Vx is equal to 5 minus 10 I1 dash. So this is one relation. Let us say this is equation number 1. And now it is a simple single mesh. So you apply KVL for this loop or mesh. So that is 5 minus 10 I dash, I1 dash, then minus 4 Vx minus 2 I1 dash is equal to 0. So this is the resultant equation by applying KVL to this particular loop. Now we know Vx value. Vx value we have found out as 5 minus 10 I dash. Substitute it here so that you will get this equation, in which only one unknown is there, that is I1 dash. So club all the terms of I1 dash together and constants on another side and take ratio of this coefficient. So what it will result? It will result 28 I1 dash equal to 15. Then take 28 on this side. So I1 dash will be 15 by 28. That is equal to 0.54 ampere. And current is flowing from bottom to top. So this is the direction of current through 10 ohm resistance. So we have found out one current through 10 ohm resistance. Then only 5 volt battery is operating. Now we want to find out if only 2 ampere current source is operating, and instead of this 5 volt battery, it will be a short circuit. So this is the resultant circuit. We have shorted this battery and this 2 ampere source is operating. This Vx is as it is. Then 4 Vx is as it is. These resistances are as it is. So now again, dependent source is there. Find out relation of Vx. So Vx, now this battery is removed and current direction is same, but only difference is we have assumed it as I1 double dash. It is I1 dash only. Okay, no problem. So this I1 dash into 10 ohm will be the drop across this, and current is flowing from bottom to top. That means this bottom terminal of this 10 ohm resistance is positive and Vx is here. So positive terminal is going away from this Vx. So Vx will be minus of this 10 I1 dash. So Vx is equal to minus 10 I1 dash. Let us say this is equation number 1. And again, these two meshes, they are forming a super mesh, as there is a current source which is common between these two meshes, 2 ampere current source. So it is a problem of super mesh. So how we are tackling problem of super mesh? We are writing one current equation for this, and then we are applying KVL for the super mesh. So these two equations we can get. So now 2 ampere current is flowing in the direction of I2. So I2 minus I1 will be I1 dash. I2 minus I1 dash is equal to 2. This is one equation, and another equation you will get from applying the KVL for this super mesh. So if you will apply KVL for super mesh, let us start from this 10 ohm. So minus 10 I1 dash minus 4 Vx minus 2 I2 equal to 0. So this is the KVL equation. Substitute the value of Vx. We know that it is minus 10 I1 dash. So club all the terms of I1 dash together, I2 together, and constants on another side. So you will get the equation of 30 I1 dash minus 2 I2 equal to 0. Let us say this is equation number 3. So you have got two equations, equation 2 and 3, in terms of I1 dash and I2. So two unknowns, two equations you can solve for I1 dash and I2. So solving these two will result I1 dash is equal to 0.14 ampere in upward direction and I2 is 2.14. So through this 10 ohm resistance, I1 dash is flowing in upward direction. Its magnitude is 0.14. Then 2 ampere current source is operating. And initially we have found out when only that voltage source was operating, that current was 0.54. So we have to add them together. So by superposition theorem, the net current flowing through this 10 ohm resistance is equal to 0.54 plus 0.14, as both the current's direction is same. So we have simply added them together so that the resultant current is 0.68 ampere in upward direction. So understood? Yes. So if yes, you note down this problem as a homework. So you have to solve this. This is from your Pune University exam, SPPU. It was asked in December 2011 for 6 marks. So this is the problem. You can take screenshot or so and try to solve this numerical. For answer, you can simulate this same circuit in the simulation softwares we know, and you can find out the result. So what is asked? Using superposition theorem, calculate current I. So I is this current flowing through this 5 ohm resistance we are interested to find. So how you will tackle this problem? One 5 ohm resistance is there, one dependent voltage source is there, and this one resistance is there, 1 ohm resistance. So these three you have to keep as it is, intact. And you will operate this 6 volt source at one time and this 2 ampere source another time. So you, while operating this 6 volt source, you will keep this 2 ampere open, and while operating this 2 ampere current source, you will make this 6 volt source as a short circuit, and then find out the currents. That's all. Okay. Okay. Now, in this way, we have finished with superposition theorem. In superposition theorem, we have seen two types of problems. One is the, if only dependent, only independent sources are present in the network, and second type of problems in which if any dependent source is present. Okay, I hope you have understood the both the types. If not, so you can see our videos. I am uploading it daily. So whether you are able to see the videos, yes. बघता येता येत का? हा मला आवाज येत नाहीये.
यस सर, बघतो.
सो लेट अस सी नेक्स्ट थिअरम, दॅट इज थेविनिन्स थिअरम. सो इन थेविनिन्स थिअरम, थेविनिन्स थिअरम अगेन देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लेम्स, थेविनिन्स, नॉर्टन्स and maximum power. In all these cases, if dependent sources are there and independent sources are there, so these two types of problems are always there. And for calculating the Thevenin voltage or Thevenin resistance purpose, usual mesh analysis or node analysis you can use. So maybe concept of super node or super mesh, you have to implement it most of the times. Okay. So Thevenin's theorem, what it states? Thevenin's theorem states that any linear two-terminal circuit can be replaced by an equivalent circuit consisting of a voltage source VTH in series with a resistor RTH, where VTH is the open circuit voltage at the terminals, at the load terminals, and RTH is the input or equivalent resistance at the terminals when the independent sources are turned off. So what do you mean by this? If any network is given to you through which you want to find, let us say, current through this one of the resistance. So if you want to find current through one of the resistance, you call it as a load resistance. Okay. So that resistance will become your load resistance. Now entire circuit is different and this load resistance is different. Okay. Now what Thevenin's theorem states, if you want to find this current IL flowing through this particular resistance RL, then what you have to do? First open this resistance. So open circuit this particular terminals. So remove this load resistance. So after removing this load resistance, find out this will become open circuit. So find out the open circuit voltage between these two terminals where the load was connected initially. Let us say that voltage is VTH, V Thevenin. That is Thevenin's voltage. And after removing this resistance, looking through this particular input, you say this is as an input. So looking through these two terminals, now find out what is the equivalent resistance of this entire network after replacing all the sources by their internal impedances, or after turning off all the independent sources, you have to find RTH value, and you have to connect this VTH and RTH in series with this load resistance. And if you want to find now this IL, IL will be simply VTH upon RTH plus RL. So this is the value of IL. This is the statement of Thevenin's theorem. I hope you have understood that. If not, it will be clear while solving the problem. Okay, so let us say it is described. This is Thevenin's theorem statement that if this is a linear two-terminal circuit and across this terminals A and B, there is a load or a resistance of which either you want to find current flowing through that or you want to find voltage across that particular resistance. Then, according to Thevenin's theorem, this Thevenin's theorem states that you open this load, find out the open circuit voltage from A to B terminal, call it as a VTH, and looking through these terminals, find out what is the internal resistance of this particular network, call it as RTH, that is Thevenin's resistance, Thevenin's voltage, and make a series connection of this Thevenin's voltage source and Thevenin's resistance along with load, and then find out the load current, or after calculating current, you can find out even the voltage across this I into RL. So IL into RL will be the voltage across that particular resistance. And how to find I? I you can simply find out by VTH upon RTH plus RL. Okay. So it is shown over here. VOC, that is open circuit voltage, you need to find across this A and B terminal. That is nothing but your VTH. So VTH is equal to VOC and RTH is equal to RN. That is looking through these two terminals, you have to find out the equivalent resistance. So these are the steps while solving the Thevenin's theorem. First, remove the load resistance, find out open circuit Thevenin's voltage, and then find out, third step is find out resistance RTH as seen from the points A and B, and then replace the network by a voltage source VTH in series with RTH and RL. So that is referred as a Thevenin's network, equivalent network. Okay. And then find the current through RL using Ohm's law, that is IL is equal to VTH upon RTH plus RL. So these are the steps while solving the problem. Let us take one example fast as time is approaching fast. Okay. So we'll complete this problem and then we'll stop. Find the Thevenin's equivalent circuit for the given circuit to the left of terminals AB. So this A and B terminals are given and this is the load resistance RL. Then find the current through RL. If value of RL is 6 ohm, 16 ohm and 36 ohms. So once this value of RL is 6, one another time its value is 16 and for third time the value is 36. Okay, means three circuits are given to you with three different loads. Okay, so since RL is only replaced, we'll solve this numerical only once and then we'll put value of RL different as one time 6, another time 16 and another time 36. So first step is we want to find, let us say RTH first. So for finding RTH, what is the procedure? First you have to open this load through which you want to find current, open circuit this. So A and B terminals will be open circuited. So A and B terminals are open circuited. This resistances you have to keep intact. So all the resistances will be kept as it is. Now, what to do about this voltage source? Voltage source you have to turn it off. All the independent sources you have to turn off. Turning off means you have to replace it by a short circuit. Voltage source by a short circuit and current source by a open circuit. So if you will replace this 2 ampere by open circuit means simply that 2 ampere current source will be removed. And shorting this 32 volt means this terminal will be connected over here. So I have shorted this. So this will be the equivalent network resulting for finding the RTH. Okay. Now, looking through these two terminals, you have to find what is the equivalent impedance of this, equivalent resistance of this, and that is nothing but RTH. So we'll start from A point. So if a current is flowing from A, it will flow in 1 ohm resistance and it will be divided at this particular junction. When current is divided means these two branches are in parallel to each other. Okay. And then current will come back again. Okay. So this 12 ohm and 4 ohm, these two resistances are in parallel and it is in series with this 1 ohm resistance. So what will be the equivalent Thevenin resistance? 4 ohm parallel to 12 ohm and in series with 1. So 4 into 12 divided by 4 plus 16, 4 plus 12, that is 16, and plus 1 is resulting me 4 ohm. So your Thevenin equivalent resistance is 4 ohm. So RTH we have found out, that is first step of this Thevenin's theorem is to remove the load resistance. We have removed that. Then second step is to find RTH. So we have found out RTH. Third step is to find VTH. So we want to find Thevenin's voltage. So what is Thevenin's voltage? After making this open, whatever voltage available between A to B terminal. So if you want to move from A to B, we can move by this path. So from A to B. As this is open circuit, there won't be any current flowing through this 1 ohm resistor. So this won't cause any voltage or it won't contribute any voltage for VTH. So what will be VTH? VTH will be drop across this 12 ohm resistance. So how to find this VTH? Either you can use, this is a simple problem now, VTH is a only node having two sources or one non-reference node is VTH. This is reference node, zero potential. So you can solve this by a node analysis. So consider these three currents, I1, I2, I3, sum them. If they are going outward direction, then you can find VTH minus 32 divided by 4 will be this current. Then VTH divided by 12 ampere will be this current. And this current, no need to find because it is directly given you as a 2 ampere current. Okay, but it is in opposite direction, so minus 2. So adding all these currents, you can find VTH. So by nodal analysis, VTH is found as 30 volt. Or you can find this, there are two meshes. So you can apply mesh analysis. And by mesh analysis also, by applying KVL to first loop, apply KVL to second loop. But for second loop, there is no need to apply KVL because current source is there and I2 is directly, you can say it is 2 ampere in opposite direction. Okay. So I2 is minus 2 ampere. And for I1, you apply KVL in this loop. So it is 32 minus 4 into I1. Minus 12 into I1 minus I2 equal to 0. So substitute value of I2 as 2 ampere here and you will get value of I1. Then you can find out I1 minus I2 into this 12 ohm will be dropped across this 12 ohm resistance and it is nothing but Thevenin voltage. And it is also giving me the result of 30 volt. Okay, so by any means you can find out the voltage, Thevenin's voltage, maybe by mesh analysis or maybe by nodal analysis. Okay, so VTH we have found out. Initially we have found out RTH. Now third step is you have to find equivalent Thevenin network. So Thevenin equivalent network is VTH here in series with RTH and then RL is there. VTH we have found out as 30 volts. RTH we have found out as 4 ohm. So this is 30 volt, this is 4 ohm and RL, three different values we have given. RL is given as 6 ohm first, RL is given as 16 ohm second time and RL is given as 36 ohms third time. And using this, what we are interested to find current through this RL, load resistance. So if, let us say RL is 6 ohm, then how to find IL? IL will be VTH plus divided by RTH plus RL. So 30 divided by 4 plus 6, 10. So 30 by 10 will be 3 ampere. So IL is equal to 3 ampere for first time. For second time, IL is 1.5 ampere and third time, IL is 0.75 ampere. Got this? I hope you have understood this. And we are running out of time. So let us stop here.